Hope is a dying commodity, so I try to hold on to stories that inspire me. And my favorite story of the year last year, hands down, was that pilot that landed that plane on the Hudson River. Sully. Sully. Right? And you know his name had to be Sully. If that was a Chad or a Winston, he would have cartwheeled that plane right to the middle of Manhattan. Man. Just up there peeing on himself. My dad's not here. I don't know what to do. Sully's like, let me finish my coffee. We'll land this bitch in the river. What do you think? I'm going to walk up and down the aisles looking for babies and hot chicks to give CPR to. I'm Sully. And where might I find Captain Jack Sparrow? That's a man right there, man. Let me tell you something. If I ever did anything that heroic in my life, I would use that argument against my wife for the rest of my life. You didn't clean up in here. I landed a plane on the Hudson River. I don't want to hear shit tonight. Of course, so you know she's like every other wife. She's heard it so many times. She's like, tell us again how you saved everybody. Birds in the engine and we can land on the river, but we can't cut the goddamn grass when I want you to. That's the joy of marriage right there, man. Another good story a couple weeks ago, British Columbia, a little boy's in his backyard playing with his dog. A cougar jumps over the fence. A cougar, not meow. The little boy's dog attacks the cougar, right? The little boy runs in the house to safety, and while he's watching from the window, his dog and the cougar are fighting, the cougar's tearing it up. The cops show up, they kill the cougar. The little boy's dog has 3 operations and lives. It's a good story, right? It's a good story, but I started thinking about it. You think that dog came home with a little bit of an attitude? Oh, you bet your ass I'm sleeping in your bed tonight, Timmy. Yeah, I'd love to wiggle my tail and beg for food, but as you can see, I don't have a tail anymore, Timmy! You imagine him trying to get that dog to go play? Here, boy, fetch! You can go fuck yourself, fetch! I fought a cougar for you! Turn on the heat. I'm gonna go pee on your bed, you little ungrateful. I've got 3 legs left. Now the scary part is, man, those were actual stories that happened. That's the world we live in. The game is now, can you keep your sanity? Because people are snapping. You know that little voice in your head that you're not supposed to listen to? You know what I mean? Somebody cuts you off, you go, God, I'd love to wreck into him right now. People are starting to listen to that voice. There's a guy in Texas flew his plane into a building. The IRS building. I heard building and plane, I went, oh shit. And then I heard IRS. I was like, well, let's hear him out. I'm pretty sure I know how that phone call went. What's that? You're taking my house. I'll bring the keys right over. You guys are on the 4th floor, right? 4th floor?